Something that I always say is, I really don't care what you believe in as long as it's not hurting anybody. What is up, everybody? This is Chris from The Rewired Soul, where we talk about the problem, but focus on the solution. And if you're new to my channel is all about mental health. And what I like to do is pull different topics from the YouTube community or culture in general to try to teach you how to improve your mental and emotional well-being. So if you're into that stuff, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell, because I make a ton of videos. But before we get started, we have a quick word from today's sponsor. Hi, are you tired of being upset, pissed off, having your day ruined because people keep citing this guy who actually went to jail for falsifying claims that vaccines are linked to autism? Well, have no worry, because the audio version of Rewire Your Anger is now available in the description below, as well as in the pinned comment, for the low, low price of $7.99. In this book, you'll learn how to deal with anti-vaxxers without getting extremely pissed off and ruining your day. All right, thank you to our sponsor for supporting today's video. But yeah, I wanted to talk about anti-vaxxers. That is a trending topic on YouTube as well as on Reddit and in other communities. And we need to talk about it because this is something that actually just hit really close to home. I was on Facebook and I saw that one of my really close friends was affected by an anti-vaxxer, all right? So I talked to her already. I let her know that I was gonna make this video. So Lindsay, hello, how you doing, girl? But anyways, Tristan actually brought to my attention that Lindsay made this post, and she said this: I recently encountered someone who was an anti-vax and blamed my daughter's genetic disorder on the fact that I vaccinated. Vaccinating didn't cause McKenna's genetic disorder and it will save her life from all the garbage that would kill her. Learn the facts. And then down in the comments below, someone was asking her about this, and Lindsay said, apparently not, since after I tried to give her the benefit of the doubt and re-explained McKenna's genetic metabolic disorder so she would understand that it's genetic and she was born with it, she still proceeded to tell me that it's what Big Pharma told my doc to tell me to trick me into vaccinating my daughter, and that really it's my fault she has this genetic disorder because I poisoned her with toxins. Like, come on, you guys. So something I always say is, like, wouldn't this world be like a better place if everybody just went back to the golden rule of don't be a dick? All right, so Lindsay and my good friend Chris, you know, they had a baby, McKenna, and sorry, Lindsay, can't remember how old your baby is. We haven't seen each other in a while. But anyways, this is rough. Like, if any of you are parents out there, one of the scariest things that we deal with is whether or not, you know, our kid is going to be all right, if they're gonna be safe or whatever. And I remember, you know, what Lindsay and Chris were going through when McKenna was born and because of this genetic disorder, all right? So because of this, there is already a lot of stress. There's a lot of anxiety. I remember Lindsay, you know, and I talking about feelings of depression, you know, and some of this was postpartum, all right? There's so much that comes along with having a child, okay? And to have somebody come at you and point blame on you for this genetic disorder is so terrible. And I'm gonna talk a little bit about how to deal with this, but you guys, like, don't let idiots get to you. Like, please, for the love of God, like, do not. Like, I was actually just having a conversation on Twitter and somebody was saying, oh, this isn't a good way to take criticism. Like, you guys, not all opinions are valid criticism. For example, this woman criticized my friend for vaccinating her daughter. That does not mean it's a valid criticism. That is a dick move, all right? So you guys, think about it, a genetic disorder, okay? A genetic disorder. This is something that McKenna was born with, all right? Long before a child can even get vaccinated, and somebody out there is pointing the blame at my friend, saying that vaccinations are the reason that McKenna has this genetic disorder. So something that I did, and by the way, this is just, you know, this is not kudos to me. I'm just trying to teach you how I try to support my friends. Like, if you see a friend posting about this on Facebook and they're struggling, like, reach out to them, ask them how they're doing, ask them if they're all right. So I reached out to talk to Lindsay a little bit and we were talking, and come to find out that this woman was actually a holistic medicine person, all right? So this is somebody who has dedicated their life to helping people and has the audacity to try to shame this woman, my friend, for vaccinating her daughter. Like, are you kidding me right now? And I have nothing against holistic medicine. I do think that we overprescribe medicines, especially here in the United States, but like to go after people with your theories about vaccinations and all that. And this, you know, this is why, like, I don't want you guys to feel bad. I don't want you guys to get depressed. I don't want you guys to get anxious. I don't want you to get angry over this stuff. Like, I remember watching Philip DeFranco the other day, and they just had an outbreak in the Northeast. What was it? Was it for measles or something? And kids who aren't vaccinated are at a huge risk. They're at a huge risk. And for me personally, like, let's talk about some, you know, relationship stuff. When my son Dylan was born was when that quack I mentioned in the advertisement. When Dylan was born, it was around the time that that guy was gaining traction, talking about how vaccinations cause autism. And Dylan's mom, she's not doing it anymore, but she actually worked with children with autism, all right? And she was afraid to get Dylan vaccinated. And that was a really hard conversation that we would have because, you know, she was pretty firm on it. She was scared, as many parents are. And this is one of the dangers of it, you know, all this stuff. Like, when I just talked about the conspiracy theory with BetterHelp, like, this is the danger about not doing the research. Like, you guys, if we can't trust science, what can we trust? You know, so it was a difficult conversation that we had. And Dylan actually got his vaccines pretty late. But I remember this, we went to the pediatrician together, and my son still has the same pediatrician, Dr. Kafour. If for some reason you watch this, shout out, you're an awesome pediatrician. But I remember he used to have conversations with us about vaccinating Dylan, and basically what he asked my son's mother was, if you knew for a fact that Dylan was going to get one of these illnesses that could have been prevented by a vaccine, would you get him vaccinated? And she said, of course. And he just let her know. He's like, unfortunately, we don't know whether or not he will get it. But you agree that if it would prevent him from getting something that he could get, you would do it. And that's when she finally agreed to get Dylan vaccinated. Dylan's vaccinated, totally fine, as are most kids, you know? But you guys, this is why I try to caution you against just like, you know, being in a bubble and listening to a bunch of people and stuff. Like, you know, again, like, I don't care what you believe in as long as it's not hurting anybody. Like, if you want to believe the earth is flat, I really don't care. You know, what's that really causing any harm to? But when it comes to vaccinations, you know, this can, you know, be deadly. This can be deadly. Tristan and I, we watch a bunch of like Reddit videos and stuff like that. And there's like an anti-vaxxer Reddit or subreddit. And it's crazy. There's stories in there about parents who didn't vaccinate their child and, you know, children passed away. Or there was one story about how their child had to get like a spinal tap. And those things are absolutely brutal. You know what I mean? So not only are we talking about physical health, but in the case of my friend Lindsay, we're talking about mental health. Like, Lindsay and I started having this conversation about being a parent, right? And one thing that is a trigger for a lot of parents is people accusing you of being a bad parent, all right? That can be very triggering. That can trigger anger. That can trigger self-doubt. You know, like I mentioned in my video about James Charles and in the book, Rewire Your Anger, a lot of anger is based on fear. So we get angry at people who criticize our parenting because we have a lot of fear that surrounds our child. So I was talking to Lindsay and I asked her how she's doing with it, what she's doing to manage it. And Lindsay actually goes to therapy. So all of you parents out there, therapy can help. Like, if you're a stressed out parent, if you have self-doubt or whatever, go to therapy. All right. So Lindsay is actually a friend who was using BetterHelp for a while. Like, she didn't have a terrible therapist. Lindsay just wanted more of that one-on-one connection. So she got face-to-face therapy once she got insurance again. So you guys, this is why I always tell you, I really don't care how you get help, just go out and get help. For the love of God, get help. Like, again, I will remind you until the day I die, mental health does not mean a lack of a mental illness. Mental health has to deal with negative self-talk. It has to deal with your worries. It has to deal with your fears, all right? It has to do with your relationships. Mental health covers all of these things. So if you are struggling, especially as a parent, because you're hanging around a bunch of parents who are trying to shame you for ridiculous reasons, make sure you try to get inside of a support group or talk to a therapist or whatever it is, all right? But anyways, let me know down in the comments below, like, have you ever been shamed as a parent? How did you deal with it? Like, let's have a conversation, okay? But anyways, that's all I got for this video. Again, Rewire Your Anger is available in both the ebook format and the audiobook format. You can get the bundle for $7.99. Check out the link in the description below, as well as in the pinned comment, all right? But if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you're new, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell. And a huge thank you to everybody supporting the channel over on Patreon. You are all amazing. And remember, everybody at the $20 tier and above, you get all my books for free, all right? So go check that out. Thanks again for watching. I'll see you next time.